Mr. Brown was a wealthy man. He owned a lot of land. Had a great big house and a great big barn and a brand new hired hand. Now Mr. Brown, he was so tired, he said he'd go away. He said that he didn't want any news, he didn't know how long he'd stay. Now Zeke, I'm going away. I'm gonna take myself a complete rest.
Yes, sir, boss, you look to me like you need a long rest.
And I don't want any news from home. I don't want to be bothered by that blame thing while I'm gone.
You ain't gonna be bothered by that blame thing, boss. Not from home. Not a word will you hear while you're taking your rest.
So Mr. Brown, he went away and whiled away the time. But finally Mr. Brown returned and he was feeling fine. Well, howdy, Zeke. I'm just feeling great. How's things at home? Is there any news?
Ain't nothing much happened, boss, since you've been gone. Yeah, one little thing, your dog died.
What? You mean old Rover died? What in the world happened to poor old Rover?
Well, you see, boss, I reckon that eating that burnt horse flesh must have made him sick, and that's what killed your dog.
Burnt horse flesh? Where in the world would he get burnt horse flesh?
Oh, I forgot to tell you about that. Your barn burnt down. Burned up all the cows and the horses, and after the fire cooled off, the dog went in, ate some of that burnt horse flesh. That there's what killed your dog.
Now, Mr. Brown, he was surprised. He couldn't believe his ears. His fine big barn gone up in smoke, and he had it all these years. My barn burned down, Zeke? How in the world did that happen?
I'm a dog if I know, boss. Unless it's cause a spark flew over from your house.
From my house? What do you mean?
Oh, I forgot to tell you about that. The candles, they caught the curtains afire, and of course the curtains caught the roof. The roof burnt the house up, and the spark flew over on the barn and burnt the barn down. Burnt up all the cows and the horses, and after the barn cooled off, your dog ate some horse flesh. That there's what kills your dog.
Candles? Why, I didn't have any candles in my house. What candles are you talking about?
I forgot to tell you. You see, they had them sitting around the coffin.
Coffin? What coffin?
Oh, I never mentioned that either, did I? Your mother-in-law died, so they had it sitting around the coffin there.
Now what happened to my mother-in-law? I want to know that.
I'll be doggone if I know, boss. I reckon, though, she must have died from shock.
Shock?
Yep. Around the neighborhood, everybody said it was from the shock of your wife for running away with that dad-blame traveling salesman. Outside of that, boss, ain't a thing happened.